In this video I show how I hooked up a 3-axis analog accelerometer to an Arduino, and I'll also show the Arduino and processing sketch I wrote to visualize the data. Alright, here's the accelerometer. I am using an Arduino Uno, and I also have an inexpensive prototyping shield from umlaut.com. The prototyping shield just plugs in, and then I'll find a nice place for the accelerometer. After that, it's time to hook up some wires. First, I'll connect the power wires. This is a 3.3 volt device, so I'll be using the regulated 3.3 volt output from the Arduino to power it. Next, I'll hook up the analog outputs for the X, Y, and Z axis, and I'll be using the analog inputs of the Arduino 0, 1, and 2 respectively. And then it's time to select the sensitivity range. It can do from 1.5 to 6 G's. I select the 4G option, which means that G select 2 is high and G select 1 is low. Okay, then there's still the sleep pin left, and in order to keep the device awake, I connect the sleep pin to high. The plan is that the Arduino sends the data collected from the accelerometer to the PC via the serial port, and to control the data transmission I add a push button, so it only sends data when I push the button down. I connect the push button between the digital pin number 2 and the ground. I'll be using pin number 2 as an input and activate the built-in pull-up resistor. This way I don't have to add another external resistor. Oh, and then there's one more little thing. In order to get the full range from the analog to digital converters, I hook up the analog reference pin to 3.3 volts also. When you do this, it's very important to set the analog reference to external in the code before you make any analog reads. If you fail to do so, you may short the analog reference, the external analog reference to the internal reference, and damage the circuit. Okay then, let's take a look at the software side. A quick estimate: I want the Arduino to send 100 samples per second, and I'm using the serial speed of roughly 10 kilobytes per second. So this gives me that every data packet must be 100 bytes long or shorter. These are just rough estimates, but it's good to check that you don't exceed those by mistake. Alright, the Arduino code works roughly like this. If the button is pressed down, I take a note of the starting time. Then I read the analog values X, Y, and Z. After that, I pass the data into some kind of a string format. Well, actually I don't, I just send them one character at a time, but it will appear as if though the serial port sends a string. I start with the letter A to indicate that a new packet starts. Then come the analog values, separated by a semicolon, and then a line change at the end. I very roughly estimate the used time for all of this. I take another timestamp and subtract the start time from this. And because this loop should be done once in 10 milliseconds, I issue a small delay, roughly 10 milliseconds minus the used time, which is also in milliseconds. So it's not that accurate, but it'll do for this. Then let's take a look at the processing code. Processing sketches call the draw function, by default 60 times per second. It's meant for drawing objects to the screen, but I'll also be doing the serial port reading in this function. There are better ways to do this, but this will do for now. If there's any data available, I just read the buffer, I pass the data into integer values, and once I get the three readings as integers, I'll just update the meters. And this goes on as long as there is more data available. At the end of the draw function, I just draw the meters to the screen. Okay, then let's see this in action. I compile the Arduino code, and you can see the LEDs blink as I upload it. Then you can check it's working by pressing the button down and opening the serial monitor. Whenever I press the button, the serial data starts flowing. And then let's run the processing sketch. It automatically draws all 3 meters, one for each axis, and when I hold the button down, the meters get updated. Four G is already quite coarse, it's hard to max out the readings, but it is doable by shaking it rather violently or slapping the device. And there you have it. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.